Halo pencinta Animal Stories Indonesia. Sore ini kami dari Animal Stories berkesempatan bertemu dan berbincang-bincang sedikit dengan Mr. Leif Cocks. Mr. Leif Cocks adalah pendiri dari Orangutan Project.
My name's Leif Cocks. I'm the founder of the Orangutan Project, and we work in Indonesia to support many Indonesian partners and organizations to protect the orangutan and its habitat.
So, I think you've been involved in this orangutan project. It's more than 30 years, is that correct?
That's correct. I've been working with orangutans for more than 30 years in captivity and in the wild. And my main aim is to save the orangutan from extinction.
Right, is it since 1998, right? So, I've been reading some about you before, mm-hmm. yeah? And I think you have also written the books. Some of them, it's called Orangutans and Their Battle for Survival, mm-hmm. which is in 2002.
Correct, yes.
Right? And the second one is the Orangutan, My Cousin, My Friends, in 2016. Mm-hmm. And they both being published. So I think it's very amazing mm-hmm. about what you did so far mm-hmm. to orangutan, because among there are so many Indonesian mm-hmm. People mm-hmm. and orangutan is a native species mm-hmm. to Indonesia,
yep.
right? But you are not Indonesian mm-hmm. and you are Australian mm-hmm. and you care so much, mm-hmm. you're paying a lot of attention mm-hmm. to orangutan
yes.
in Indonesia
mm-hmm.
and that's come up with
Being kept in captivity and deprived of the correct social contact of who and when we need to interact with gives them long-term stress, which eventually makes them die very early.
Alright, so how old was Puan? Is she like 56?
No, Puan was well into the 60s. I think she must have been about 63, 64 years old.
So is that a good age or she can live longer if she's out there? Mm.
Well, we really don't know because we've only been studying orangutans formally for about 45 years. And so orangutans that were studied 45 years ago are still alive today. But because orangutans are the slowest reproducing species in the world, we believe they must at least live into their 60s in a while.
All right. So I think it's about 60 for Puan. It's very good. Yeah. It means that she's been very well taken care.
Exactly. She's one of the few orangutans that lived what we believe to be a natural lifespan in captivity, where the most orangutans will die a lot earlier than that.
All right. Okay. Mm-hmm. And so what do you think? Doesn't have to be precise, mm-hmm. but approximately how many orangutan left in Indonesia, mm-hmm. and in which part of Indonesia can find them the most?
Yeah, there's actually three species of orangutans.
Oh, really?
Yeah, in the Bornean orangutan, there's about 55,000 left.
55,000.
Yeah, spread over at least three subspecies. In Sumatra, there's two species of orangutan, the Sumatran orangutan, and there's about 14,000 left. And there's 800 of a new Tapanuli orangutan, which was only discovered a couple of years ago as a distinct new species. And of course, unfortunately, all three species of orangutans are threatened with extinction. By their very definition. So replacing the rainforest with unsustainable monocultures such as palm oil and pulp paper allow a few people to get very rich, and the vast majority of that money doesn't stay in Indonesia, it goes overseas. But what's worse than that is taking away the financial opportunity from Indonesia's children and grandchildren, because when these unsustainable ecosystems which are monocultures eventually collapse, it's Indonesia's grandchildren which are going to have to suffer the lack of economic opportunity from a failed environment. And lastly, of course, the rainforest provides immediately environmental services to the whole of Indonesia through water catchment, reducing temperature, increasing rainfall. So we see already, once rainforest disappears, where before they had a steady river flowing for their crops, they now have floods which destroy their villages and droughts which destroy their crops.
Climate change.
Exactly. Not only for the world, but even for the local communities. I characterize it most accurately as a few greedy people are destroying Indonesia's future at the expense of the many, which includes the local people, the orangutans, the indigenous communities, because the rainforest in Indonesia is not empty, it's full of people who live off the rainforest, such as the orang rimba. But most of all, I'm worried about Indonesia's children. Their opportunity is taken away.
So, do you think that the authority in Indonesia at the moment has been doing a good job in handling the flora and fauna and protected animals in this country?
Yeah, unfortunately the rainforest ecosystems still are disappearing at a great rate, and therefore, you know, we would expect that, you know, the ecosystems which support Indonesia's future in agriculture and industry are being undermined by, I guess, our collective inability to save the rainforest.
Do you think it's too late to save the rainforest?
I think we have a very big challenge on our hands to save the rainforest. However, the Orangutan Project's goal is to work with our partners to save 5 to 8 complete ecosystems of rainforest where orangutans and other wildlife can survive this extinction crisis, and to a future that we can hand on to the Indonesian children, so that wildlife and ecosystems can be rehabilitated and expanded in the future.
Okay. So, can you name your partner in fixing the environment, the ecosystem in Indonesia?
Well, we have many partners to achieve our aim. We have great Indonesian organizations such as the Center of Orangutan Protection, led by a really passionate and fantastic group of young Indonesians. We also work, for example, in Bukit Tigapuluh with our partners Frankfurt Zoological Society and WWF Indonesia to lease large tracts of rainforest to help save the ecosystem. And in Aceh, we work with a wonderful organization, again led by a courageous Indonesian, the Forum for Conservation of Lusa, and we support their ranger program and their efforts to save wildlife in Aceh. So what we do is we try to partner and support a whole range of organizations in order to most efficiently effect meaningful change on the ground for orangutans, wildlife, and for the future of Indonesia.
So, I think about 2 months ago, there is some devastating news about what happened to orangutan in Tapanuli.
Mm-hmm.
So, if you can give us a little bit an update about what's going on with this case.
Yeah. I mean, recently it's been described, the Tapanuli orangutan, as a new species, and it's the most rarest great ape in the world. Unfortunately, it's under immediate threat of extinction by plans for a Chinese company to build a dam in the middle of its ecosystem. And we believe that this dam has no long-term value for the Indonesian people and can be very damaging for the whole community. Plus, for hydropower, can be easily replaced by geothermal power in the area. And so we believe that it's in best interest of Indonesia, the local people, and to save this beautiful new species of orangutan, that the dam doesn't go ahead and we protect the remaining forest and connect the fragmented populations of the Tapanuli orangutan.
So how many Tapanuli orangutan left now?
There's about 800 left.
About 800
left. That's correct, yes.
Okay, so it's the dam project, it's still going on, or?
Yes,
it's
yes.
Postponed, or?
It appears that the dam project is still going ahead, but we'd like to appeal to everybody involved, and the finances and the government officials, that this is something that's really not in the best interest of everybody, and have a look at the facts to determine what is the best course to go forward.
So any progress with your effort?
There's a great group of people in North Sumatra and Aceh, working at all levels to move things forward. At the moment, it's still up in the air, on whether we're going to get a good result, which is very frightening. It's amazing that in the 21st century we can discover a new species of great ape. And it's also frightening that in the 21st century we may allow it to go extinct for no good reason.
Okay. So if the project is established, right, and running, so it's 100% sure that it will demolish all the orangutan in that area.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is what the scientists are telling us. They've studied the area and they believe that the dam would fragment the populations so they can't breed and therefore cause inbreeding. But also then the project itself and the roads and infrastructure will give poachers and those who are going to be an illegal loggers access to the forest and the orangutans to further fragment and damage the population.
I see. Okay. We know that at the moment that the palm oil, mm-hmm. or in Latin we know as elais, mm-hmm. right? I think it's the major commodity, mm-hmm. which is used. Mm-hmm. By many people in Indonesia, mm-hmm. right? And it's become a custom from many years ago, mm-hmm. that they use this palm oil as a cooking oil, mm-hmm. For their daily basis. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And can you please? Maybe you have any thoughts about, mm-hmm. so how to reduce the use of the palm oil itself, mm-hmm. so which I think at the end can lead us to help to preserve, mm-hmm. the orangutan, the existence of the orangutan.
Yeah. I think we shouldn't focus on a particular product like palm oil, because I think that gives us the wrong idea. If the rainforest is destroyed, it doesn't matter whether it's replaced by palm oil, pulp paper, coconuts, sugar palm. It doesn't matter. The forest is gone. What matters is that we destroy the ecosystem services which support Indonesia immediately. What matters is these monocultures are not long-term sustainable and therefore do not support Indonesia's long-term economic interests. So, we can, let's say if we stop using palm oil, if we do not protect the forest, it'll be replaced for pulp paper or, some other product. And so, I think just singling out palm oil gives us the wrong idea how to solve the problem. The right idea is to support Indonesia with effective land use planning, and to support local communities, and their rights. And for a long-term future, and to build a future where the economic interests of Indonesia children is predominant, and this will also allow the orangutans and indigenous communities to survive long-term in the future also.
Okay, so I think you have told us enough about the orangutan, mm-hmm. so maybe you have a message that you, mm-hmm. want to deliver to our followers, mm-hmm. in Indonesia?
Mm-hmm. The main message is orangutans are beautiful persons which share our planet, and they're critically endangered, which means they're soon to go extinct if we don't do something. And so together we can work to save them. But the most wonderful thing about doing that is if we save them and the ecosystem, we'll also be saving the long-term economic interests of Indonesia and helping save the children of Indonesia. And if anything, we must at least love our children.
Okay, so thank you, Mr. Cocks.
You're
for
welcome.
Your time.
Thank you.
And sahabat Animal Story, begitu bincang-bincang kita sore ini dengan Mr. Cocks, the founder of Orangutan Project. So, see you next time. So, Mr. Cocks, we would like to give you something small, something to remember. It's a souvenir. It's a bracelet. and it's written, I stand for animal rights, which is I think and I believe you do. So by buying this bracelet, that you give a, we give a donation for the animal welfare. So it's a unisex bracelet.
Thank you very much.
It might look small, but it's unisex, so it's for male and female. Cool. Your God can wear
it. Thank you very much. I'll wear it with pride.
All right. Thank you.